Okay, so let's put a variables block into practice. So what we're going to do is we're going to take these ones and zeros that refer to the can channel and create variables for them. So we can call them can channel 1 and can channel 2 without confusing the array number with them. So I'm going to start by creating a constant in, call it channel 1. So what this is saying is that we're going to set this integer on startup, and that's it. We can't change it anymore. It stays throughout runtime to this value that we set it at. Reason why we're doing that is we're going to put that in here on the onCan message hook. The onCan message hook requires a constant int for a channel, so you can't go changing it during runtime and confusing those hooks. So we're going to do the same thing with channel 2. What we'll do now is we'll go through and change all the values to our new integers. Now you can see that we replaced all of these values with our variables. So what we can do is if, let's say we're going to use a 5-channel device, maybe we want to use channel 2 and 3 instead. So what we can do is we can come up here and change the variables, recompile, and it allows us to reuse the same code a lot easier than going through and finding and replacing all the values. So that's how we can utilize the variables in our T scripts to make things a little bit more easier to read and reusable.